Anxiety is a feeling of worry, nervousness, or unease, typically about an imminent event with an uncertain result. It's the unknown. And with anxiety comes fear. Fear is defined as an unpleasant emotion caused by the belief that someone or something is dangerous. You know, God will have you do things that are completely out of the norm. He will have you do things that most people, you included, would see as not a good idea. Things that make no sense. That's because the faith life isn't of this world. It doesn't work like the world does. Most of the time, it works in the exact opposite ways of the world. It's one thing to know God's word. It's another thing to believe God's word. God isn't looking for the knowers. He's looking for the believers, the doers, the ones that live out this faith like it's actually true, because it is. Because faith isn't just a one-time thing. It's not just a one-time commitment. I believe in Jesus for my eternal salvation. It's a lifestyle. It's a lifestyle. I've been crucified with Christ. It's no longer I who live, but Christ who lives in me. And the life I live now in the flesh, I live by faith. So many Christians want to do. I have to do this to please God. I want to do that to please God. You really want to please God? Have faith. Simple faith. Without faith, it's impossible to please God. God, it doesn't look like it. It doesn't look like what you said is going to happen. But you're God. And you rule over all. And you have already proven yourself faithful in my life. I know you can do all things and that no purpose of yours can be thwarted. So I'm walking by faith. I'm living by faith. I'm marching to that hill by faith. I have no idea how you're going to do it. It doesn't look like it, but you said, and you don't lie. Therefore, it's already done. And because of my faith, I'm going to live as though it's already happened. I'm going to overcome the situation. I'm going to give you the praise and the glory now, even though I don't see it. I'm going to say no to fear, no to anxiety, no to doubt, and I'm going to live as if I already have victory, in victory and peace, with freedom and joy, giving thanks and praise. Because God is not man that he should lie, or son of man that he should change his mind. Has he said and will he not do it? Or has he spoken and will he not fulfill it? How sad it is when someone in victory lives as in defeat. Stand firm. Don't be afraid. Don't be dismayed. The battle is not yours. It's God's.